Hey guys, it's Sebastian from AskSebi, and today we are going to talk about building out your 5-card base if you're looking for cashback credit cards. So we're not really talking about travel cards, and there are a lot of assumptions that we're considering. Firstly, you do not care about 524, so this is a Chase 524 rule, so you're not really optimizing towards this because you're not someone who really travels. If you are someone who cares about that though, if you see yourself taking a trip in the next 1 or 2 years, I would kind of consider that, and again, probably fill out a consultation on our website, that way we can talk about strategy. The other thing that we are going to assume is that you're looking for no annual fee cards. And the main reason there is because there is a lot more complexity if you do argue for certain cards once you have the travel credits and stuff like that. For this video, at least, let's keep it simple and focus on cards that do not have annual fees, because I think people who are looking for cashback cards probably don't want to pay those annual fees anyways. The final thing for this video is that we are not really considering people who are high net worth. So there is kind of an interesting setup if you have more than $100,000 with Bank of America as well as Merrill Lynch. But for this video, at least, we're not considering that. Let me know if you are interested in that video though. I'm not really sure whether this video is going to be more of a listicle one or whether it's kind of more about base building. We'll kind of do both and we'll see what happens. So the starting point is going to be that you either have a student card or that you have a secured card. And the reason for that is just to build credit. For the purpose of this setup, I'd recommend something from Discover or from Citibank, and the main reason is due to easy product changes for future useful cards. So you get this card and you use it for 6 to 12 months. You prepay your credit card off in order to keep the utilization low, ideally less than 10%, ideally probably at 0% or 1% if anything, and that way your credit score should probably be at about 700 right now. And then what you want to do at that 6 to 12 month mark is to start applying for one of the starter cards. Depending on which card you got as your first card, I would probably pick the difference card, so the opposite card, as your first starter card. So let's say you got the Citi secured card, I would get the Discover It card next. If you got the Discover student card, I would get the Citi double cash card next. With the Citi double cash card, it's a pretty much catch-all card. And again, if you don't like Citibank for whatever reason, you can also get the PayPal MasterCard, which is effectively the same thing. I typically recommend the Citi card though, just because you kind of want to build history with some of the bigger issuers in case you want to get other cards in the future, or in case, again, you want to do a product change to a more useful card. When you go with an issuer who doesn't have as many cards, or if you go with someone like a credit union, the main problem is, in the future, if your habits change, which they probably will, then you're not really going to be able to adapt your cards to that. You're either going to be forced to cancel it, or to just not use it. The case for the Discover card is that it's a 5% back card, based off different categories. So pretty straightforward, you just need to look at the categories once every quarter, so once every 3 months, and just use the card when it's appropriate. One thing I really like about Discover is that they have Discover deals, which typically grant you between 5 to 20% off or cash back at different places. And then in your first year, you have cash back match, doubling all of the cash back that you get. One other benefit of the Citi double cash card is that Citi right now probably has the best price protection program out there in terms of their willingness to match it and also whether it's going to stay around long term. So again, if you want to buy a lot of things and you want to get matched to that lower price, Black Friday being a very good example here, then I think the Citi card makes a lot of sense. Assuming that you got the starter card in month 6, then in month 12, they should graduate the initial card that you got, the secured card or the student card, into an unsecured one. At this point, I'd recommend getting a Chase Freedom card, and even if you don't care about 524 or getting ultimate reward points, I think building that history with Chase is not a bad choice, and the Freedom card is another 5% back card. Again, same idea as the Discover It card, rotating categories, just use it when it's appropriate. After this Chase card, I would probably look into something like the US Bank Cash Plus card, and the main reason is because they are pretty inquiry and new account sensitive, so getting this card earlier if you want it makes a lot of sense. Again, another 5% rotating category one, but instead of them dictating the categories, you can pick your own. I'd recommend going to their landing page to see whether these 5% categories make sense for you, and then if it does, again, consider the card. The interesting thing is that with most of these issuers for cashback cards, they seem to be pretty new accounts and inquiry sensitive, but again, US Bank is kind of on another level for that, so you do kind of want to space them out, probably one every 6 months. Unlike the travel ones, I don't really think you can do too many at the same time. For gas, this means getting the Ducks Unlimited card, which gives you 5% back on all of your purchases, and I believe there's no cap. For groceries, this means getting the BCE card by American Express, so this is the Blue Cash Everyday card. the Blue Cash Preferred card might make more sense. You might want to crunch the numbers, but for the purpose of this, we're going to assume that the BCE card makes more sense. If you're someone who eats out a lot, then I think the Uber card makes a lot of sense. And again, there's a lot of other benefits there, so I definitely think it's worth considering. So with that, I think we have 5 or 6 cards. So the Secured or Student card that we had, the Starter card, the Freedom card, US Bank. But again, pick the ones that make sense for you. It might not make sense to get all of them. So if you are someone who lives in the city and you don't have a car, getting the Ducks Unlimited card doesn't really make any sense because you're not really going to put that much money on gas. Again, you could make the argument that, well, you could buy gift cards at 7-Eleven because oftentimes that codes as gas. So yes, that works out. But again, just trying to keep it simple for the sake of this video. On that note, if you are looking to apply for any of these cards and you want to support our channel, a really easy way to do that would be to apply for the cards using the links on our site. Some or most of them should be available under cashback cards, so take a look. So I hope that was helpful, and let me know if you guys have any questions. My question for you guys is, which of these 5 cards would you pick? Let me know in the comments down below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, it really helps us out. And if you know anyone else who benefit from what we just talked about, feel free to share this video with them, because it's probably going to help them out. But otherwise, hope you guys liked it. See you guys next time.